I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God.
I, Henry, take you, Jane, to be my wife, and to have my heart from this day forward,
for better for worse,
for better for worse,
for richer for poor,
for richer for poor,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
till death us do part,
according to God's holy law,
in the presence of God,
I make this vow.
I, Jay, take you, Henry, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward,
for better for worse,
for richer for poor,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
till death us do part,
according to God's holy law,
in the presence of God,
I make this vow.
Jade, I give you this ring
as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
It's close enough.
Go on, Garen.
Yeah.
Give me the microphone.
So, what's under the kilt? Not a lot. I thought I wouldn't do a long speech.
Hey, it's only been long.
I was actually going to bring a toilet roll. Firstly, I'd like to
thank you all for coming to what is the most glorious field in Devon.
Yay! Thanks, Hilary and Robert!
If you're from the border, this is what it's like on the right side of the border.
Why? Oh,
hey. So I found myself last week at home with the pets with a list of jobs to do, getting in preparation for the wedding. So one of the many tasks was to write the speech. So you do everything that you do, you Google it. I tell you now, there are some right rubbish on Google. But the key information was that I'm the warm-up act for the groom and the best man. Why did the physics teacher break up with the biology teacher? See, I told you what Google was rubbish. I've seen the picture. Okay, the jokes were rubbish, I know. So let me begin with a brief history on Jade. My firstborn. Back when I was a mere young pup at 23, in the wee early hours of 15th of March, Jade literally came flying a month early into life. And when I say flying, I mean flying. If Sarah and I didn't catch, Jade would have hit the floor.
Move on quickly.
So as Jade grew up, she's always been very, very, maybe another very, independent, and has always known her own mind.
I wonder where she gets that from now.
No idea.
It's definitely Gary. Sorry,
particularly when it came down to which Disney movie she wanted to watch.
Oh man, seriously?
Not once.
Oh my God.
Not twice.
Do you not remember?
Maybe a thousand times we saw Pocahontas. Maybe a few more. She loved it so much we even came into it today. Then it came down to the Disney dinner mats. If Jade got the wrong Disney dinner mat, that was it. We were in trouble. So, shall we do an embarrassing story?
Yeah.
There are many.
Which one?
One of the particular favourite ones was we were going shopping in Sainsbury's, and Jade decided to see if her knee would fit in between the barriers. Just to find out.
No.
Then with a child screaming her head off, panicking people coming running here, there and everywhere, trying to move these heavy barriers where the trolley park is to release this child's knee. Eventually we didn't have to call 999. We did manage with sure view, Russell, we got it out. And then there was the time we went to see the Mighty Palace, who won again today. Palace were playing crew, and this lovely chap behind us shouted, Ref, you need glasses. To which Jay turned around and went, Daddy, why does the ref need glasses? At that point we decided that, you know, we'd leave what happens in a football stadium in a football stadium, and we wouldn't tell her mum.
Good blooming job as well.
Jade, I'd just like to tell you that I love you so much. I am awfully proud of you. You're becoming a very beautiful young lady. The future's going to be bright with Etty.
Terrible itch.
Terrible itch, mate.
you know, you've obviously got Dom, you're heading off to uni, you're moving house next week. We've got the next thing to look forward to. And where can I start on Henry? Just to keep it fair. The first time we met was a bit of a double whammy. It was a good news day though. One thing I can say about Henry is he's such a laid-back chap, he is horizontal. As I was ringing him at 9:30 this morning, where are you? I'm up at the field. I'm watching Transformers! And I might watch G.I. Joe! But we've managed to pull the day together, the sun's come out. You guys are great. So... Can a dad give some advice to you? Well, after 28 years of marriage, I still need advice.
Don't wear a kilt. Just ask Ali.
Remember, you're in this together.
Dom, where are you going?
He's off, he doesn't like granddad speaks. No, maybe not. Try not to sleep on an argument. And remember, Henry, Jade is always right.
Yes!
And lastly, yes! Mate, remember to talk to each other. No, I mean really talk to each other. Look, we're almost there.
Yeah, we got tax and it's
fine. When I got married to your mum a few years ago. I remember Gran said to me, I needed a gold medal. Can I just say, I don't
I
think
forgive you for that. You know that,
I deserve the gold medal. I think it's a joint effort. We both should have got one.
Yes.
Because if you invest time together, yes, you come out winning.
Yes.
And before I finish, yes, I am finishing. This is only a joke.
Yay!
I'd like to thank a few people for coming.
Yay!
Grant, Zeus, thank you for so much you've done. Can I just say, Grant, thank you for doing the message there. It's really great news for doing that. And as a little gift for you, I know just so much how much you love them. We've nicknamed them Grant and Zeus.
We've nicknamed them Grant and Zeus.
But don't worry about it. I knew that you wouldn't accept them. So Jay's taking them. Thank you so much for travelling down and doing your beautiful interlude for us.
We like an interlude.
We do like an interlude. Just so you know, Mark's CD is available on iTunes. And if you want to sign a copy, I'm sure he's got some in the boot at the back of the car. And Jen, thank you so much for all the jam making, helping us with order and service, and everything else that you've pulled together. By the way, I'm talking to Frank.
Callum.
Yo.
Shit.
Sorry.
Thank you.
And Ali, well, I think we did a reasonable job with this one.
Yeah.
At last, she's gone. One down, two more to go. Finally, my toast is not Happy New Year, Mum. Sorry, I had to get that one in there.
Thank you.
Let me raise a glass to the happy couple. Jane and Henry.
Googled what best man's speech was meant to be.
Best man?
Who's best man?
Wrong wedding.
Shit. I
hope not. Wrong one. Quite frankly, all I could find was there's just to say thanks to people. So I'd like to say thanks to the groom's party for the help and for a banging stag do.
No, I bet.
You're all like dotted around places. Rob's got a little summit for everyone.
The entrance.
Can you? Yeah. I didn't check the name tag because I don't really have much to say. Gary's already said thanks to everyone for me, so I'd like to say thanks to the bridesmaids. You're all looking good in your nice teal.
Yes.
I think we've got a good colour match. No. And we've got a little gift to them as well.
As a bride.
That's just what that person
is.
Watkin! I'd like to say thanks to my dad. He brought me up. Like, taught me how to do most things. I'd like to say thanks to Gary. No, I've got bullet points that I did at 11. About half 11 last night. I did me too. Technology. Taking notes from Grant. And I'd like to say thanks to my mum. Rob. I'd like to say thanks to my mum.
The gifts. That way.
That's basically what you're saying.
Oh, you could have said that before.
No, I'd like to say thanks to Jake for actually turning up.
You're still punching!
There's a little something for you as well. I'd like to say thanks to everyone for turning up.
This is the most fun
I've
ever been.
Now for Bailey's speech, let's all get pissed and have a dance.
Yeah!
It's going to sound so stupid this part, but it's supposed to be a joke. There comes a time in someone's life that they meet their true love, their soulmate, the person that's going to know them and love them for the rest of their life. And that time comes to Henry 15 years ago when he met me.
Love you, bro.
Who anyway, said romance was dead, huh?
Bailey Hegan, mate. I think this is for you.
Anyway, for those who don't know me, I'm Bailey. I'm Henry's brother from another mother. James still hasn't been told that he's adopted, sorry. But yeah, I feel like I'm on trial today, to be honest, because Henry said if I do a good job today, then I can be best man at his next wedding. Jokes aside, to be asked by Henry to be his best man is an honour for me. And it was, yeah, an honour for me. And it's, I've lost where the fuck I am. Oh, there you go. It's an honour for me. It's very nice for Henry and Jade to dress up so nicely for me, for it, to be honest. But it's also very honourable for him because he's finally admitted to every one of you that I am the best.
Dreamer.
You know? Public speaking, I've heard that public speaking is very much like going to a nudist beach actually. The first few minutes are always the hardest, so, you know, let's crack on with it to be honest. Firstly, I'd like to say how beautiful the bride Jade looked today, and how beautiful the bridesmaids are looking too. Yeah. I also have to thank Jade for giving me such a handsome godson, Dom.
Yeah.
Bless him. Anyway.
We make beautiful babies.
Anyway, gentlemen, I'm sure you'll agree with me today that today is a sad day, as never beauty leaves the available list. And ladies, I'm sure you'll agree with me today has passed without much of a ripple. Henry, did I? Sorry, mate. Henry did ask me nicely not to mention any past relationships, which sadly has cut the speech by about 3 seconds. But he's the man of the day and I respect his wishes.
He's only just started,
don't
Henry.
Don't spit it.
I'll never do.
I know you two are close, but damn.
Henry and Jade first met paths downtown, as far as I'm aware. Jade first told me. First crossed paths downtown. Told me the first time they ever met, she thought that he was handsome from afar, but on closer inspection, she thought he was far from handsome. The first time Henry introduced me to Jade, I remember thinking how friendly and bubbly and how easy she was to talk to, and always hoped they went the distance. From then on, I always said to Henry, she's a good un, or us lads say, a definite keeper. Also, Henry and Jade have just moved into a new house, and I think it needs a little bit of DIY, to be honest. but Henry has assured me that after today, there's going to be a lot of banging and screwing after every opportunity. I had no input on this.
Bailey, seriously.
It's a little bit inappropriate. It's inappropriate, but it's not actually involved. No. None of good employment. No comment.
Has he got a cordless?
I do actually.
None of you would know this, but I've already congratulated Henry already. Henry, I said, well done. You always look back at this weekend as the happiest and the best thing you've ever done. Fitting words after a fantastic stag do, I may say. Also a big thank you to the stag do party. Just to finish off my speech, I'm going to give you four bits of wisdom. Number one, never go to bed on an argument. Always stay up and argue. Number two, to remember your anniversary, yep. Just forget it once. Number three, remember these three little words. You're right, dear.
Here.
Number four, to all of you couples that are here today, turn a face to one another and look deeply into each other's eyes. Go on, crack on. Now, scientifically proven, the person that you're looking at is most likely going to marry you. And just to finish it off, I do have to say...
Stop!
I do have to say, though, Henry... I do have to say, Henry, just how lucky you are. You'll leave here today with a wife. It was warm, loving, caring. And Jade, you're lucky as well. You'll be leaving here having gained a lovely dress and a wonderful bouquet. Thank you. Yeah, if you raise your glasses and a toast for Henry and Jade.
Henry and Jade.
My sky, they wipe away tears that I